Hi everyone, welcome to Gateway Lectures. Today we have a good numerical from thermodynamics. Let us see. 1 ton of liquid water at 20 degrees centigrade and 80 kg of ice at minus 5 degrees centigrade is brought into a well-insulated and well-sealed. The dimension of the room was given initially at, and the room was initially at 15 degrees centigrade and 95 kilopascals. The specific heat of water is 4.18 kilojoule per kg degree centigrade and the specific heat of the ice is 2.11. Kilojoule per kg degree centigrade. The latent heat of fusion is 333.7 kilojoule per kg. Assuming that specific heat for ice and water is constant, the final equilibrium temperature in the room, correct to one decimal or two decimal places. Here one important statement to note is, assuming the specific heat for ice and water is constant, mean whenever we are discussing about specific heat is a parameter which depends on temperature also, for gases generally. Here ice, water was a liquid and ice is a solid which will be converted into liquid. There is no vapor here. There is no gas involved here. So that is why ice, for ice and water specific heat is constant. Let us solve this question. Here it is a well sealed and well insulated room. So what does it mean by well sealed and well insulated room? When it is said that well insulated, then the meaning is there is no heat interactions. There is no heat interactions, and we'll discuss what is the system here and what is the surrounding here. There is a special thing to know here, and what is meant by well sealed. Well sealed means there is no mass interaction, and also there is no work interaction. No mass and no work interactions. Right. And here, when this ice and water are brought into a room, the room dimensions were given, but the volume or it is not given that ice is in which volume and water is in which volume. So after getting into the room, we don't know any, is there any space left in the room for the air to interact. So directly what here we assume here is, because we don't know whether there is no space left for the ice or water heat interactions with the 15 degree centigrade room. So directly we take our ice and water as our system. So this ice plus water is taken as system. Ice and water is taken as system, and the surrounding is outside atmosphere. Okay, the surrounding is outside atmosphere. So ice and water is a system. Since it is a well insulated and well sealed room, this can be called as an isolated system. This is an isolated system or isolated room. Okay, for isolated system, if you can observe, the heat interactions is zero and the work interaction is zero. So from this we can say that internal energy change will be zero. By first law of thermodynamics, we know Q is equal to del U plus or delta U plus W. Since Q is zero and W is zero, delta U will be equal to zero. And what is the delta U? Here delta U is for system. So when we talk about delta U of system, it is for both ice and water. So it is for delta U of ice and delta U of water. Okay, here if you can observe what were the interactions, what were the changes in ice. Here in question, it was given 80 kg of ice but 1000 kg of water. So water content is more and also specific heat of water is more. So there is a most chance that ice, complete ice will be converted into water because water capacity, heat capacity is more than ice. So it is a chance that complete ice also will be converted into water, but water also will lose some heat to the ice. Since ice gains the heat, the same heat is given by water to the ice. Okay, here we will see. So the ice which is at minus 5 degrees centigrade, it will initially go to ice at 0 degrees centigrade. So here there is a sensible heat involved for ice. And this ice at 0 degrees centigrade will be converted to water at 0 degrees centigrade. This is a latent heat involved, latent heat of fusion involved. And when this, and again this water will go to a final temperature T, let that be some T degrees centigrade. We don't know the temperature, that is the final temperature we need to calculate. And regarding water, water is at 20 degrees centigrade. It gives heat to ice and it goes to a temperature T degrees centigrade, which is less than 20 degrees centigrade. Okay, now we'll do some calculations here. For delta U of ice, if we can observe, it is mass of ice into specific heat of सॉरी स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ आइस इंटू टी फाइनल माइनस टी इनिशियल. टी फाइनल इज 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड टी इनिशियल इज -5 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. सो 0 माइनस ऑफ -5 प्लस लेटेंट हीट इन्वॉल्व. सिंस आइस फ्रॉम 0 डिग्रीज टू आइस टू वाटर एट 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड इट इन्वॉल्व लेटेंट हीट. सो मास ऑफ हाइट इंटू लेटेंट हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन एंड प्लस अगेन द सेम मास ऑफ आइस इंटू हियर नाउ इट इज कम्प्लीटली कन्वर्टेड इन वाटर एंड दट वाटर इज ऑल्सो अगेन रिसीविंग सम हीट फ्रॉम द वाटर एट 110. So it is converted to T degree centigrade. So here MC of water into initial temperature is 0 and final temperature is C. So it is T minus 0 plus this is the total internal energy change for ice. And coming to internal energy change for water, it is mass of water, specific heat of water into final temperature is T and initial temperature is 20. So it is T minus 20. And that completely should be equal to delta U of the system should be equal to 0. Okay, now we'll do calculations. Mass of ice 80 and specific heat of ice is 2.11 into 0 minus of minus 5 is 5 plus mass of ice is 80 and latent heat of fusion is 333.7 kilojoules per kg plus mass of ice is 80 into specific heat of water is 4.18 into T minus 0 nothing but T plus mass of water is 1 ton 1000 kg into specific heat of water is 4.18 into T minus 20 and this completely should be equal to 0. And by calculation we get the T value or the T final value will be equal to 12.42 degrees centigrade. This is a good question involved. Many will be getting confusion why room conditions were given. Here room conditions should be given because room will also have some temperature and pressure. They should be given. But one more thing here we need to assume is it is said that they are brought into the well-insulated and well-sealed room, but it is not said that there is some space left for the heat interaction between the ice, water and the room air. So we need to assume here is the water and ice completely occupy the entire room and we have to take the ice and water as our system. This is a very good numerical and thanks for watching. Thank you.